Alright, we're back with episode 4 of Let's Play Dragon Age Origins. We have the Rod of Fire, and now we have to go find Jowan again. He's in the chapel, I think. Yep, over here. Going to the chapel, and we're gonna get married. Alright, I'll stop now. Maybe he's not. There he is. Okay. And what's her name? Lily? Yeah.
I hate waiting. It makes me nervous.
I have the Rod of Fire! Wait no more.
That was quick!
To the repository then. Freedom awaits.
Yay, alright. So it seems like, by this plot and First Enchanter Irving's words earlier, the phylacteries of apprentices are stored here in the tower. And when they become full-blown mages, they're sent to Denerim, which is the capital, and presumably where the Templar headquarters are to keep them safe. And that makes sense. Because an apprentice isn't that dangerous, and they're not normally powerful enough to get into the phylactery chamber down here. But because they have the help of a full mage and a plan, they can do it. And Lily's help too. So it does make sense as a plot. Now we have two party members too, Lily and Jowan. Yeah, they look how similar they look. All right, here's the basement. Down we go. You can actually have up to 4 people, including yourself, in the group at the same time in this game, which I actually forgot about until I was looking up some stuff about it. So it's unlike KOTOR or Dragon Age in that sense. Oh, I'm sorry,
the
or Mass Effect.
The gentry calls this entrance the Victim's Door. It is built of 277 planks, one for each original Templar. It is a reminder of all the dangers those cursed with magic pose.
How do you know this?
Initiates must learn the Circle's history if they are to work with Templars and mages.
It looks just like any other door.
The doors can be opened only by a Templar and a mage entering together. The Chantry provides the password, which primes the ward, and the mage touches it with mana to release it.
Interesting. So it's an enchanted door, I guess. And that makes sense. Normally it would be probably Gregor and Irving opening it. Yeah, since you have the password, why can't Jowan help you enter?
The ward only responds to the touch of one who has been through the harrowing.
So you have the password?
Yes. I got it from a Templar who recently accompanied a mage into the vault.
And he wasn't suspicious?
We have chatted on many occasions. I believe he trusts me.
Yes, so.
First the password. Sword of the Maker, Tears of the Fade.
What was that?
The password only primes the door. Now it must feel the touch of mana. Any spell will do, but hurry.
I guess it chooses different spells based on what spells you know.
Do you have the rod with you? Melt the locks off.
Perhaps later. I want to see what he says to that.
Later? If you haven't noticed, we're not out for a leisurely stroll in the woods here. Give it to me, I'll do it.
Nothing happens.
Lily, something's not right. I can't cast spells here. Nothing works.
These wards carved into the stone. This must be the Templar's work. They negate any magic cast within this area. I should have guessed. Why would Gregor and Irving use simple keys for such a door? Because magical keys don't work. How do you keep mages away from something? Make their powers completely worthless. That's it then. We're finished. We can't get in.
There's gotta be a way around this. That's interesting though. I didn't know they could do that. Like if you could make areas immune to magic, why don't they do that more often? It must be very hard to do that and take a lot of power. That door there, where does it lead?
I don't know. Do you think it's another way in?
That door probably leads to another part of the repository. What are the chances of there being another entrance?
Yeah, it's not foolishness, it's their life we're talking about, so it's worth a try.
We can't get into the chamber the way we planned, but we're not about to give up. We can see where this door leads, but I don't think it'll be easy. It looks locked for one.
Onward then.
Let's hurry, we've wasted enough time.
And the rod will probably work on those logs.
I'm not giving up.
On those
we've
locks,
come
rather.
Too far. Oh, that's not good.
Yay. Oh. I saw that suit of armor there. I wonder what it was for.
Shall we go?
Don't like this.
As you say.
This bodes well.
It's funny, this game actually taught me how to play a MMO before I even played one. Because it's basically set up like that with aggro and tanks and DPS and healers. I can probably explain that a little more as we go on, but...
Enemies approaching.
Basically, a tank is the character whose job it is to grab the enemy's attention. And you build a tank to be bulky and defensive so they can take a lot of damage. A healer is just what it sounds like, the person who's responsible for keeping the group alive and healing off the damage they take. And DPS stands for damage per second, and their goal is to do as much damage per second as they can. So they're basically just the damagers who kill the enemy. So it's a nice... It's the Trinity is what it's called. It's a nice combo. It works very effectively. You don't have to play the game this way, but you could just have four people all attacking random things. But if you're going to be strategic about it, that's probably the best combination.
It shall be done.
Oh. Just grasp. Bolt. He resisted that freeze. It seems.
As you say.
So she seems to be a rogue.
Why can't they leave us alone?
Our skill has won the day. I shall do it.
And Jowan is a mage, I would assume. Class-wise, at least. We can, I guess, look up their stats if you really want to. Yep, there's Lily. And there's Jowan. And there's me. Yeah, not really a fan of these robes.
As you say.
But that's okay. Unfortunately, I think there are only two robe models in the game, at least for player characters.
Enemies approaching.
Oh, we have lots of enemies now. And one of them has magic. Robe sentinel.
Why don't you just die?
I'm gonna heal myself.
Very well.
He healed himself too.
You say.
Got him.
Very well.
Take that!
Our skill has won the day.
I guess you can probably just click on the player, on the character itself, too. Yeah. It's a kind of a weird system. All the clicking involved, but that's okay. Yay, an autosave. It's gonna be a boss fight or.
Shall be done.
Deep Stalker. Basically a magic rat.
It is begun. Our skill has won the day.
Kind of. I don't know. They're kind of dinosaur-like. They're creepy, whatever they are. And there's more of them. Deep Stalker leader. I do remember these guys, actually.
Don't give them the advantage.
They're in caves a lot of the time.
There is no glory in bloodshed.
I guess you can continue left click on them. Okay. Okay. So when I'm right clicking, I keep accidentally moving my character instead. Yay. Like I said, on normal, the game is not hard at all. Why do I have. What is this? Oh, I'm playing Jowan now. I clicked on. See, that's the trouble part two, is you click on them to use a spell on them, but then when you click on them again, you become them. So he has different. He can use flaming weapons, for example, which makes all of our weapons do a bit of fire damage. And that's a persistent spell. There's the buff there. So it takes up a bit of your mana, see. but you can keep it on. Is there not a rotate character button? Or do I just not have it mapped to something easy to reach? Not sure. Honestly, I probably don't need the turn character keys, because keyboard turning is not nearly as quick as mouse turning. Which is what I'm used to anyway. Storage cabinet. Yay, more stuff and a potion. But I will mess with the keybinds some other time.
As you say.
Alright, so we're getting pretty deep in here. We've got company. Let's kill the sentinel first. So yeah, if you want to be very strategic about it, you can pause the game all the time.
Very well.
And take control of your group mates.
Be careful. The maker is with
tell them what to do all, you know, every single round. But you can also give them tactics, which is probably what I'll do once I have like a real party with a lot of different abilities. Which is like when group mate falls below 50%, use heal spell and things of that nature. So that's pretty cool. Alright, I can level up. So let's give... I'm just going to keep stacking magic and willpower, at least for now, because I don't see why I wouldn't. Those are my mains. I mean, you could give some to constitution, I guess, if you wanted more health, but ideally I won't be getting hit a lot. Alright, we could do improved coercion. Let's go with that. And we have a new spell point. You need to have more magic. So most of the spells have a magic requirement. So it might be useful to stack points into magic for now. Cone of Cold I remember being really good and a lot of fun to use. There's so many good abilities though. Oh, do we only get 20 abilities? Because that's not really a lot, come to think of it. One per level, I guess. Let's go with Frost Weapons, because I do want that. At least I think... I know you can get to at least level 20, because there's an achievement for that, but I'm not sure if there's actually a cap at level 20 or 25, maybe.
Very well.
I'll have to look that up later as well. A new amulet. Might as well equip that, I guess. The Apprentice's Amulet. Actually, I'm going to keep with what I have. The willpower is probably more useful.
It is begun.
Another belt. I'm not going to worry about that right now. Do a quick save. At least the quick save is actually quick. Not as quick as Mass Effect, where it would save as you can walk around, which is really awesome, but this is the next best thing, I suppose. So let's try... See, now you can give them... Oh, can you do both? Why am I not attacking things? There we go.
Best be wary.
Yeah, I do not like this system. Heal me.
I can't keep this up.
Watch out, Jowan. Everybody attack this guy. I probably should heal Jowan, but it will. Yeah, I really missed the auto targets and all. Those were very helpful. Yay, copper. Not sure how money works in this game. Is it like 100 copper make a silver, 100 silver make a gold? Something like that. We'll figure it out. But that's interesting, you can get both frost weapons and flame weapons at the same time. I assumed they were mutually exclusive, but I guess not. So that's kind of cool. I was going to say it's only useful to go for one or the other, but if you have multiple mages in the party, you might as well go for both.
More enemies ahead.
Wonder if the same mage can cast both things. I also really miss, from Mass Effect, the everyone attack my target key. That was really useful. Definitely seems like... Well, I don't know. I was about to say, once you have enough spells, you could probably...
Very well.
not really worry about the auto attack anymore, because that's not really true, because you still have the mana to worry about. I really wish there was a way to see my health without looking way up in that corner of the screen, because I have a 27-inch monitor, so it's pretty... It takes a while for my eyes to get from there to there. They're dashing back and forth between my cooldowns and my... Can you do it? No. What? No, that's just locking it. Swap weapons. I was going to see if maybe there was a way... Well, I guess you can select the whole party. Huh. We'll figure that stuff out later.
We'll need another way into the phylactery chamber. Let's explore the repository.
I think you can bind a hotkey for it, too. Just select the entire party at once, which could be really useful if you are trying to do a everybody attack this target thing. You said I need another thing? Can I go in this door? No. I can. Ah, oh, you liar. What's in here? Ooh, a nice staff. Very nice. Let's equip that before we forget. I don't like the design nearly as much. It's basically like a bent stick, but we'll go with it anyway. Some cool statues and stuff in here. This is like the mage's treasure room where they keep all their artifacts. That thing's weird. It's like Fluffy from Harry Potter, but not as cute.
Wow, that old wall's about to come down any moment.
What wall? That one over there? There are some roots coming through it. Is that sunlight? That can't be sunlight. Seems like a way to escape if you really wanted to. Although I don't know how you get up there. That's cool. A model of the solar system maybe or something? Not sure what the cosmology is in this series, if there is one. It's one thing I really like about Elder Scrolls. They really flesh out the entire world. Even the heavens and the gods and oh, what's in here?
I think the phylactery chamber is on the other side of the wall behind this bookcase.
You're not suggesting we break down a wall.
Look carefully. The mortar's damp and decaying here. We should be able to find something that can knock some of the bricks loose.
But the bookcase is in the way.
If we work together, we can shift it. Come on. Now we just need to find a way to get through this wall.
Well, that statue was clickable, so probably that.
Shall be done. Use this with the rod. I'm sure it'll work. Hurry, the clock's ticking.
Aha. That did it.
This is the phylactery chamber. It worked.
We must find Jowan's phylactery, quickly.
Where would it be?
With the other apprentice phylacteries, I imagine.
No, you don't say. You can say it's a pity to take a mind to Denerim, but I'm not going to say that, because...
It shouldn't be hard to find.
I don't want to be an apostate. There aren't many phylacteries here. At least not yet.
More enemies ahead.
Uh-oh.
As you said. I shall do
I'm not afraid of you!
Oh, a Sentinel Guardian. It's a higher rank. The yellow names mean lieutenant, I think. I'm trying to remember what the ranks are called for enemies. I think there's like normal creatures are like really weak, like these little things we face at the beginning. Then lieutenants, and then...
Let's try not to die here.
Are there two more levels, like champion and bosses or something? Something like that, I think.
It shall be done.
Or semi-champions and champions. I'll have to look it up again at some point. Alright, so there's the other door, which is now... No, it's not open. There it is. So yeah, you can easily open it from this side, just not from the other side. But we still need the phylactery. So that was a boss fight, basically. What is this stuff? Like magic snow? I wouldn't touch that. There's some phylacteries. Old ones, by the looks of it. They're very irregular. I kind of assumed they would all be like the exact same size, like in like a wine rack kind of thing. Be very nicely organized, but I feel sorry for whoever they took that much blood from. That had to be Make you a little woozy. Especially if they're younger. You see Joan's phylactery in a corner of this case.
That's my phylactery! You found it! I can't believe I guess they're labeled. This tiny vial stands between me and freedom. So fragile. So easy just to be rid of it. To end its hold over me. And I am free.
So you might want to, like, I don't know, clean that up or hide it, because they could probably still get a sample. Yeah, I expected a larger room and many more phylacteries.
Only apprentice phylacteries are stored in the Circle Tower. This tiny room could not hold the phylacteries of every mage who has passed through the tower doors.
Come on, you two, we're done here and we should leave.
It's also safer to keep them in Ferelden, obviously. Alright, let's move on.
I do not want to stay here a moment longer.
Quest completed. Why do I feel like this whole thing was a little bit too easy? Something's got to go wrong. Back outside.
We did it! I can't believe it! Thank you. We could never have...
So what you said was yep. True, Evan.
I knew this would end badly.
Gregor.
An initiate conspiring with a blood mage. I'm disappointed, Lily. She seems shocked, but fully in control of her own mind. Not a thrall of the blood mage, then. You were right, Irving. The initiate has betrayed us. The Chantry will not let this go unpunished.
How did he know, though?
And this one. Newly a mage and already flouting the rules of the Circle.
I'm disappointed in you. You could have told me what you knew of this plan, and you didn't.
You don't care for the mages. You just bow to the Chantry's every whim.
Yeah, I could have told him and been a tattletale, but... I mean, yeah, I could let my best friend be turned into a tranquil. That would be rough. So you can try to talk him down. You can say he's right. Or you can say the first enchanter does what he can. He seems like a pretty good guy, so I'm not going to yell at him. But I do want Jowan to calm down, because yelling at the two of them is only going to make Gregor more mad. And I can't protect him.
Enough! As Knight Commander of the Templars here assembled, I sentence this blood mage to death. And this initiate has scorned the Chantry and her vows. Take her to Aenar.
Well, that didn't end well.
The Mage's prison. No. Please, no. Not there.
No! I won't let you touch her!
Uh-oh. Blood magic.
By the Maker. Blood magic. How could you? You said you never...
I admit, I dabbled. I thought it would make me a better mage.
Blood magic is evil, Jowan. It corrupts people, changes them.
I'm going to give it up. All magic. I just want to be with you, Lily. Please come with me.
I trusted you. I was ready to sacrifice everything for you. I don't know who you are, Blood Mage. Stay away from me.
Well, that's kind of tragic.
Are you all right? Where's Gregor?
I knew it. Blood magic. To overcome so many. I never thought him capable of such power.
Yeah, I didn't know about that, so he lied to me.
None of us expected this. Are you all right, Gregor?
As good as can be expected given the circumstances. If you had let me act sooner, this would not have happened. Now we have a blood mage on the loose and no way to track him down.
This did end kind of poorly, but at the same time, Jowan, he doesn't seem like he's a evil, power-hungry person. So hopefully the blood magic doesn't really corrupt him, and hopefully he does give it up. It's a shame Lily didn't go with him. She probably would have been good for him to talk him out of using it and keep him on the straight and narrow, but I expect we'll see him again at some point. He can't have gone far. You could still capture him.
Believe me, We will use our every resource. Where is the girl?
I am here, sir.
You helped a blood mage. Look at all he's hurt.
Lily didn't know.
You've been a friend, but you needn't defend me any longer. Knight Commander, I was wrong. I was accomplice to a blood mage. I will accept whatever punishment you see fit. Even Aenar.
Get her out of my sight. And you. You know why the repository exists. Some artifacts, some magics are locked away for a reason.
Did you take anything important from the repository?
The staff. You can lie to him, and if you have a high enough persuade skill, I think you can keep that staff. It's a shame, it is a good staff, but if it's dangerous, I'm not sure I'm going to be carrying around with me anyway. Yeah, I'll say yes, this staff.
Shall we add thievery to your list of misdemeanors, then? I'll be taking that back now, if you don't mind.
But your antics have made a mockery of this circle! What are we to do with you?
I did take some coins, and I think some potion ingredients, and other stuff too. This is an RPG, you're kind of supposed to take things. Yeah, I'm gonna say do what you like, I stand by my decision.
You helped a blood mage escape! All our prevention measures for naught, because of you!
Knight Commander, if I may, I'm not only looking for mages to join the King's army, I'm also recruiting for the Grey Wardens. Irving spoke highly of this mage, and I would like him to join the Warden ranks.
Duncan, this mage has assisted a Malefica, and shown a lack of regard for the Circle's rules.
He is a danger to all of us.
It is a rare person who risks all for a friend in need. I stand by my decision. I will recruit this mage.
I'm glad you see it that way, Duncan.
I refuse to let this go unpunished.
Say, if the Grey Wardens will have me, I will gladly go.
Rhaegar, mages are needed. This mage is needed. Worse things plague this world than blood mages. You know that. I take this young mage under my wing and bear all responsibility for his actions.
A blood mage escapes, and his accomplice is not only unpunished, but is rewarded by becoming a Grey Warden. Are our rules nothing? Have we lost all authority over our mages? This does not bode well, Irving.
Enough. We have no more say in this matter.
So I am to be a Grey Warden?
Yes. Be proud, child. You are luckier than you know.
Thank you for everything, First Enchanter.
Come. Your new life awaits.
And that's the Magi origin. So no matter which story you choose, Duncan is there and eventually recruits you to the Grey Wardens. The origin story just gives you a background and a couple levels under your belt. It does come into play later on, then.
We will be
later
traveling
on, though, a couple
south
times as well.
Through the hinterlands to the ruin of Ostagar, on the edges of the Korkari Wilds. The Tevinter Imperium built Ostagar long ago to prevent the Wilders from invading the northern lowlands. It's fitting we make our stand here, even if we face a different foe within that forest. The King's forces have clashed with the Darkspawn several times. But here is where the bulk of the Horde will show itself. There are only a few Grey Wardens within Ferelden at the moment, but all of us are here. This blight must be stopped, here and now. If it spreads to the north, Ferelden will fall.
Ho there, Duncan.
King Caelan. I didn't expect
a royal welcome? I was beginning to worry you'd miss all the fun.
Not if I could help it, Your Majesty.
Then I'll have the mighty Duncan at my side in battle after all. Glorious. The other wardens told me you'd found a promising recruit. I take it this is he?
Allow me to introduce you, Your Majesty.
There's no need to be so formal, Duncan. We'll be shedding blood together after all. Ho there, friend. Might I know your name?
You can be a wise ass and say, I highly doubt it, but anything is possible. I'm just gonna say, I am Aerevale, Your Majesty.
Pleased to meet you. The Grey Wardens are desperate to bolster their numbers, and I, for one, am glad to help them. I understand you hail from the Circle of Magi. I trust you have some spells to help us in the coming battle.
I will do my best, of course.
Excellent. We have too few mages here. Another is always welcome. Allow me to be the first to welcome you to Ostagar. The wardens will benefit greatly with you in their ranks.
Real welcome, then. Nice. I like his guard's armor. His armor's cool, and so is the guard's. Let's see. We'll see about that.
I'm sorry to cut this short, but I should return to my tent. Loghain waits eagerly to bore me with his strategies.
Your uncle sends his greetings and reminds you that Redcliff forces could be here in less than a week.
Ha! Eamon just wants in on the glory. We've won 3 battles against these monsters, and tomorrow should be no different.
That's right. I'm starting to remember some of the characters now. Loghain is his advisor and a friend of his father's. The previous king, King Merrick, who died a while back. And Earl Leoman is the Earl of a city to the north. We'll meet him later. I didn't realize things were going so well.
I'm not even sure this is a true blight. There are plenty of darkspawn on the field, but alas, we've seen no sign of an archdemon.
Disappointed, Your Majesty?
I'd hoped for a war like in the tales. A king riding with the fabled Grey Wardens against a tainted god. But I suppose this will have to do. I must go before Loghain sends out a search party. Farewell, Grey Wardens.
Careful what you wish for. Not really sure we want a full blight in our hands.
What the king said is true. They've won several battles against the darkspawn here.
An interesting note, too, is that even though we're in the far south, it's cold here because Ferelden is in the southern hemisphere of Thedas, which is the world of Dragon Age. So it gets warmer as you go to the north. You don't sound very reassured.
Despite the victory so far, the Darkspawn horde grows larger with each passing day. By now, they look to outnumber us. I know there is an archdemon behind this, but I cannot ask the king to act solely on my feeling.
What would you have him do?
Wait for reinforcements. We sent a call out west to the Grey Wardens of Orlais, but it will be many days before they can join us. Our numbers in Ferelden are too few. We must do what we can, and look to Terran Loghain to make up the difference. To that end, we should proceed with the joining ritual without delay.
So, Ferelden is kind of like medieval England, and Orlais is like France, and there are Grey Wardens throughout the entire, throughout the world, I think, or all the nations that are in this region, at least. But only a few here. What do you need me to do?
Feel free to explore the camp here as you wish. All I ask is that you do not leave it for the time being. There is another Grey Warden in the camp by the name of Alistair. When you're ready, seek him out and tell him it's time to summon the other recruits. Until then, I have business I must attend to. You may find me at the Grey Warden tent on the other side of this bridge, should you need to.
Alright, sounds good. So we have made it to Ostagar and completed our origin story. Yay! It's cool too that from what you determine in game, it seems like all 6 of the origin stories take place simultaneously, but which one you choose is the one Duncan happens to be at, and thus you're the one he happens to recruit. So the other 5 characters exist, but they all meet unfortunate ends because he's not there to save them or to get them out of trouble or to recruit them. Alright, so that's episode 3. When we come back, we'll explore Ostagar and become a Grey Warden.